easy scenes with the father remembering all the good times with the daughter pushing her on the bike and playing basketball with her. And so it's a time of nostalgia, but it's a joyous time in addition to that, because, you know, it's a joy of seeing your daughter, and in your case, the dear daughter's son, growing up to be a man, and, you know, and remember growing up to be a woman, and seeing quite the special people that you become. And so it's really joyous in that sense. Guess what I want to say? A couple of quick things. America, the math of marriage is very strange, because two people become one. You know, you've got different backgrounds, different experiences, and you come together as one person. On the other hand, it's somewhat exponential, because the two you marry, and now you've got your son, little Dan, but you've got all these other people that you didn't have before. So, and that requires that, and by the way, I can speak about this a little bit with authority, because my wife's a woman, and so that requires that you have patience with each other, first of all. And that you work on the oneness of your marriage and blending all the different things we have. We have different personalities, we have different backgrounds, different experiences, lives, and dislikes. You have to figure out how to blend that. But you also have to figure out how to bring in and recognize the additions that you have. You know, the added mom that you have now. And Margaret, and the added moment now that you have it, and the deer goes through. So you have to learn to blend all of those things. And if you learn to do that, and if you learn to forgive each other as I to you have forgiven me, then everything's going to work out very well. So you can expect some ups and downs, but in my case, it's been mostly ups. You know, Dan, Kenneth told me, he told me about praying with you. And he told me that you're such a fantastic guy. One of the joys, again, of marriage is that Kenneth has, in Parima fighting,